Welcome to yet another tutorial. In this one, I'm wanting to pump some water, so I'm going to make myself a hand pump. All three. Now, the first one I'm going to make is a sludge pump, and I found this piece of PVC pipe, a 4-inch one, on the street, thrown out, chopped it half, joined together again. And the next thing to do is make a plug for the bottom. Now, I'm going to have to measure that to find out how big to make the plug, and that is 110 millimeters. Now, because it was going to be a circle of 110 millimeters, I want 55 radius. So I'm going to just mark out 55 down that way, and 55 from this edge, and 55 there. So I know I'm now going to put a nail through there, right through the center, right through. Now, you could do this on a bandsaw, a fretsaw, jigsaw, bench or whatever, but let's do it manually. I get another stick like that, and then I put it onto that so that it's now level with the end of that, and nail it in. So now it's going to turn. Then I can turn that over, and then I'm going to use that as my guide to cut it off. Then turn it around and cut it off. And turn it around and cut the point off. And keep turning it around, and you keep on cutting off the points, and you just keep going around, taking off those lumps and bumps. And depending on how accurate you want to be on your thing, you'll get it more and more circular. And if you need extra precision, you can use a smaller saw or a rasp or something, and just level it off as you spin it around. And then even get some sandpaper like that and spin that around so that you're gonna get it nice and circular, so that eventually it's going to fit nice and precisely into the end of your pipe. Next thing to do is mark out a little bit of a circle inside that circle, and then I'm going to drill a whole bunch of holes in that circle until you get something similar to this. Right, now I'm going to make the valve. If I was to take a thin piece of plastic like a margarine container, that's really good, but I'm going to try some Coca-Cola bottle here, and I'm going to put it on, and I want my flap, I'm going to cut a circle that's going to go outside of those holes, and then I'm also going to add a tab, so something like that, where I'm going to attach it there. Cut that out with your scissors, and then you want to place it on top, and then I'm going to attach it with either a nail or a screw, or in this case I'm just going to staple it, so that now that will flap up and down, so that the water shuts it. When you suck it, it opens, lets the water through, then it shuts again with the weight of the water. Then I'm going to put the valve side, the plastic side, into the pipe. Then screw a hole, make a hole, or nail, or screw that in there, so then it is solid. You may want to put several, just to make sure it's not going to fall out. Now, if the edges around here are not very sealed, you can put a bit of silicone there, or, but you will find that by the time that that gets wet, after a little while, it will swell and those cracks around there will seal and it won't leak quite as much. Now the next thing I'm going to need is a plunger. So I'm going to cut another circle and it's going to fit into the pipe, but reasonably loosely, because that will, when it's wet, will swell up and jam. So you want it slightly looser so it'll go in there. Then we're going to get a stick or a broom handle or something, and we're going to attach it to there with a screw through the middle. But before that, we've got to make the valve that goes on it. And so I'm just going to mark out where my stick's gonna go, roughly. And then I've got to either cut some holes. Oh, I'm going to do a couple of big ones here. And then the same material, preferably flat, that's a little bit curved. But anyway, I'm gonna make that so that the plastic covers those holes that I'm going to make here, okay? You could make them out of a whole bunch of smaller ones as well, or a big one like I'm doing now. And then I'm going to allow for a place to staple it here. It's going to go over my hole here, but it's got to go enough room for the other stick and back around. It's going to make it roughly that shape. And then once it's cut out, place it over there so it's going to block those holes. And then a staple should do okay, so that those now will work as valves. And through that center hole, I'm going to just make a little bit larger to put my screw through. So I have from the opposite side the screw going, and then I've drilled a hole in that one, and now I'm going to screw that onto there, like that. And so now that's going to go down in there into the pipe. So now to test it, I'm going to put it in this barrel and up there. And plunge it down. Now it is quite heavy. And that's a fair weight of water because it's a 4-inch pipe and everything, but it does shift quite a volume a reasonably short distance. Now lifting that water about a meter and a half. Now if we had a hole that we had that down into with some water and we had our pipe in here into the water, and it's like that, we could at the top put a T section and a piece of pipe to run that off with. But it is quite important that we have a little bit of a head on there so that enough when you pump it up, it fills up here and then can drain out of here. So I'm going to have to do something alternative because I don't have a T of that size. I'm not going to buy one either. So let's do something different. Now here I have one that's a bit shorter, and in the end I just made one hole with its valve in there. So I'm going to measure at the top, maybe give it a couple of hundred millimeters, and I'm going to put my outflow pipe somewhere around there. And I'm going to use one of those size things to put it onto there. Now over a flame, I'm going to take that and I'm going to carefully heat it.
just rotating it over the flame, maybe slightly lower. Now it gets up to about 77 or 70 or 80 degrees before it starts to go soft, about 70 degrees Celsius, so don't burn yourself. And at the same time, I got a pole that I can then put up there so that it fits snugly, because I'm going to need that very shortly. Now when it's soft, which it's not yet, you take it out to the pipe to flange it. And when it's hot, we're going to put it down on that pipe so that it splays out, and also put our other one in there, our wooden one, so that it's going to spread out and flange and take the shape and the curvature of that big pipe. Let it cool. Now I could glue that there. I've got to mark around there, drill a hole out and glue it, but since this is green to yellow, it doesn't glue very well, so I'm going to screw it, and I haven't got any glue anyway, so let's do that. Pilot hole. Accuracy is not too much of a problem. Okay. Now I've only put a couple of very small screws that I've rescued from some electronics, just so that I can place it so I can mark it. I'll probably put a whole bunch more of those little things, and I don't want them to protrude all the way through the pipe so that it gets in the road of the plunger. I'm just marking it out. And then I want to cut a hole that's inside the size of that flange, about that size, so I've got room to screw other screws on. So I'm gonna cut that out with the drill. I'm also using a keyhole saw as well, so that I now have my hole that's gonna let the water through my pipe.
And so, here we go.